When we learned about kinetics in previous videos, we saw that for first-order processes, the integrated rate law, the natural log of the ratio of the concentration of A at a time t to the concentration of A at time 0 is equal to negative kt, and that we can use this equation to calculate the concentration of a reactant at a given time. We can use a similar equation for radioactive decay to calculate the number of nuclei remaining at a given time. This equation tells us that the natural log of the ratio of the number of nuclei at a given time to the nuclei originally is equal to negative kt, where k is the rate constant and t is the time. This equation can be rearranged to provide a more direct means of getting to the number of nuclei remaining, so that the number of nuclei at time t is equal to the number of nuclei at the original time multiplied by the exponential function raised to negative kt. In this problem, we're told that plutonium-236 has a half-life of 2.86 years. If a sample initially contains 1.88 milligrams of plutonium-236, what mass of plutonium-236 remains after 5.20 years? In order to begin this problem, we might want to start out by identifying what we're given and what we need. We know that the original amount of plutonium-236 is 1.88 milligrams. We know that the half-life for plutonium-236 is 2.86 years. And we know that the time involved is 5.20 years. We're asked to calculate the amount of plutonium-236 remaining after 5.20 years. Because of this, we'll need to use the equation from the previous slide, n sub t equals n sub 0, e to the minus kt. This indicates we're going to find the rate constant first. In order to find the rate constant, we can use the relationship between the half-life and the rate constant. When we rearrange it to isolate the rate constant, we get k equals 0.693 divided by the half-life, which is 2.86 years. This gives us a rate constant of 0.242 years. Now that we have the rate constant, we can plug in the values into the equation that we're given, so that the amount of plutonium-236 remaining after 5.20 years is equal to 1.88 milligrams multiplied by e to the negative 0.242 reciprocal years times 5.20 years. The reciprocal years cancels out the years, and we get 1.88 milligrams times 0.283. When we multiply this, we find that after 5.20 years, we will have 0.533 milligrams of plutonium-236 remaining. After watching this video, you should be able to use a first-order integrated rate law to calculate the amount of a nuclide remaining after a given time based on the half-life for that nuclide.